Yes, a little bit more enthusiasm. Can everybody hear me?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. That's more like it. So, hi everybody, my name is Moises Castillo. I'm the president of the Society of Physics Students at UTB. Now, here we have my friends. We all study physics or do a part. Physics, yeah. So,
yeah, physics!
Yeah! There we go. So, I say physics, but who here actually knows what physics is? Does anybody know what physics actually is? Yes. Oh, I see a hand right there. What is physics? That's very good, actually, when you move. Now, physics is the study of the natural world. It's everything. We look at things, physical objects, moving, electricity, magnetism. We study all those things. Now, how many here have an interest in science and math? I see any hands? All right, I see some hands up there. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, all right. So, I don't know, maybe after seeing this, you might get interested. So, here, I'm going to have some friends help me out. So, here, I have a pump and a balloon. So, right here. This is my friend, Jing. Everybody, welcome, Jing. So, you see, here, he has a pump. Here he has a pump and a balloon. Okay, you're gonna have to hold on to that. So, as a pump and a balloon, can someone tell me what's going on here? Go ahead, yell it out. What's going on?
Yellow.
Very good. I see a hat over there. So what's going on? Very good. He said exactly what's going on. He's stuffing the balloon with air particles. So he's pushing them in. And the air particles have nowhere to go. So what will happen if he keeps on going? Yeah, very good. So this will be a little lag. So get ready. Thank you. I guess it's ready now. So, okay, it's ready. All right, so we have a balloon. Now, what do you guys think will happen to the balloon? I hear some breeze, I hear some pop. Let's look. What's going on? Hey, where's the balloon going? It's shrinking. So, let's see. So did it break or what do you think happened? It burned? Well, if it burned and made a hole in it, it wouldn't be doing this again. It's filling back up. Alright, so the particles inside, the air particles inside do the same thing that we do whenever we're cold. What do we do when we get cold? So we get close together and we tighten up and we get so the air particles are doing the exact same thing. All the air particles, they like to be out and about, and then they start getting cold and they start realizing, hey, it's getting really cold in here. So then they start coming together and they get really small. So what's going on with the flower? What do you think will happen with the flower? There we go. It's frozen. So here, go ahead and listen to this. It's completely frozen. It becomes so brittle that it's almost like glass. Can anyone tell me why this happens? It's cold. Yeah, well, one of the things is that flowers, just like humans, have a lot of water content inside of them. That's why we can't just put our hands into the liquid nitrogen, because we would freeze as well. And the flowers contain a lot of water inside of them, so it makes this possible. Let's hear it again. Ready? So do you have another flower? So you can see. This is a normal flower, so let's go ahead and hear the normal flower. Alright. So I see we have a banana cooking. Is a banana ready? Alright, so we have a banana in here. And of course it didn't pop and it didn't get smaller, so what do you think happened to this banana? It's frozen solid. Now, if you ever need a hammer, you know, and you have a banana and have liquid nitrogen lying around.
Hear it boiling. where do you guys see this in nature?
So that's pretty close, actually. Yeah. So what Newton said was that objects at rest. Yes, actually, yes. So good, good one. Objects at rest tend to stay at rest. So all the things that were on the table were not moving. So then he pulled the tablecloth right out of under them. So they stay there. And does anybody know what that's called? So that's a very good question. So it's called inertia. That's the law of inertia. So here you get the same sort of feeling like whenever you're in your car, you know, or in the bus. Whenever the bus starts going, you're sitting down, you're not doing anything. What do you feel whenever you're on the bus? Yeah. So the bus starts going and you go, whoa, you fall back into the seat. Nobody in the bus is moving. You're sitting down, and then the bus pushes you forward. Yeah. So this is some way where you see it every day in your life. So now we have the rope. The rope. Alright. So here we go. So every once in a while at the physics department, we get bored and we need to come up with games to pass some time. So we have this handy rope. Now here we're gonna have a team right now. So here's the supporting. Right now it's just one versus one. Alright, so I need someone here in the middle to judge. We're gonna play some tug of war here. So someone go ahead and look at the rope, make sure that you're right in the middle. Okay. So you're ready? Who do you think will win? Okay, well let's see. And go! they move? A little bit. I think you guys need some help. I think that's what's going on. You guys need some help. So go on, teams, assemble. All right. So here we have three. Let's go. So we have three against three. Okay. To make it even. So one girl, two guys. Okay. Now ready? Go. It seems pretty. It's pretty much the same. Nothing's going on. All right. Wait. Hold on, guys. Let's see. Whoa. How can one?
Two, three, four. Oh, whoa. It's broken.
Oh, okay.
It's broken.
So, what was that?
It's broken.
It's broken? Oh, man. All right. So, what do you guys think? Why would that happen? No guesses? Maybe she was pulling too hard. Pull a little softer. All right, here we go. Ready? One, two, three, go. Maybe it's the ground. Maybe it's like slanted or something. So let's turn it this way. So it's facing this way. Maybe it's the ground. Yeah. Let's try it like this. Ready? Now, 3, 2, 1, go. Oh. All right. So what's going on? What's going on? But actually, I already said what was going on. The objects move in the direction of the force being applied. The force is being applied in this direction. There's nothing to pull it back. So in which way is it going to go? It's going to go in the direction in which you're pulling. So even it didn't matter how the rope was being pulled around the spool. So thank you very much. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to look at the ropes again. So let's come on, volunteers. So here we go. This time, it's not tug of war, actually. This game's just a little bit different. It's almost like a test of strength, right? So here we have 1 versus 1. So in this game, what we want to do is we want to make the rope as straight as possible. We want the rope as straight as possible. Yeah? You guys got it? Cool. Alright, now actually I need a volunteer. I need one volunteer. Again, round of applause. Superman. All right. So, what do you guys think is going to happen right now? I remember seeing him last week. He was filling out some applications for NASA. If I remember correctly. Yeah, everybody, I do have to warn you. This is kind of loud, and do not try any of this at home. This is great. Oh yeah, or school. No, don't try this anywhere. Or park, and anywhere to go. So, all right, guys, ready? Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna count from five, and we're gonna count down as we do in that. So ready? So here we go. Five, four, three, two, one.
Ready?
Yeah. So now it's your turn. Ready? With all your mind, you're just gonna blow it. If you can, I want you to make it into that basketball. Come on, it's all physics. Come on.
We did bring the toilet paper roll, so, and we do have the leaf.
Alright. So for this, we actually need the tarmac up here. So, how many of us have beds out there? That is good, yes. Now, at the physics department, sometimes, you know, we study very late in the night and we're doing homework and sometimes we get tired, so. But unfortunately, this is the only bed that we have, so. It's a bed of nails, so go ahead and take off the top so everyone can see. And can you lift it up a little bit so everyone can see the, get an angle view of this. Now, here we go. These are real nails, and that is real blood. I'm just kidding. So here we go. Now, we're missing our pillow. Yes. Now, here's the pillow that we use. It's very comfortable. And these are real nails, all right? Oh. So that's a real banana, as you can tell. And now, he's a goner. He's a goner. Alright. That's a real banana. Those are real holes. And that's alright. So who here is tired?
Me.
And I'm in the park, I guess. I saw him studying late last night, so let's go ahead. You can have him. It's okay, everybody give cheer mantra. Alright, so here we go. Ready? We're gonna count. Now. No, he's good. All right. Now, what's going on here? There's a lot. We just saw that what happened to the banana. You know, great forest went down. The banana went all the way down. Wow, he didn't go down. So let me ask you this: if there is one nail on the ground, would you step on it?
Yes.
No. You cannot do that because then you would have a nice big puncture in your foot. All your weight, all the force is being put on that one little nail. Now what we did here is we have a lot of nails, so all that force of his body is being evenly distributed along all the nails. So all the nails are working together to actually hold him up. So it's not just one nail doing all of it. Very good. Okay, can you walk on the nails? I'm not sure, but at this time, no. At this time, no. But thank you so much, guys. Those are the, here he is, he's on the nails. Alright, so. Alright, so yeah, this is his feet are fine. So, these are a couple of things that using some math and science, you know, a lot of people throughout history came up with these ideas through observation, and now we bring these ideas to you. So, let me ask the question again. How many of you guys are interested in science and math? I see some more hands up this time. Yeah, let's show them. That's very good. Thank you so much. My name is Moises, and President of the Science Society of Physics Students. Here we are from the University of Texas at Brownsville, the Physics Department, and friends. And thank you so much. I'd like to thank the principal. I'd like to thank the teachers and administrators who are present for inviting us, and Joy for coordinating and inviting us. Yeah. Again, thank you guys for having us.